My name is Megan, and I'm a first-year doctoral student at the University of Texas at Austin. I did my master's research here for the previous 2 years, and before that, I did my bachelor's at the College of William & Mary in Virginia. Between my bachelor's and graduate school, I actually took a gap year in which I was a teaching assistant and a research assistant for the geology department at William & Mary. Geoscientists who study plate tectonics are interested in understanding the processes that made and continue to shape our world. And part of what makes this realm of geoscience so interesting to me personally is the ability to integrate multiple disciplines to get at those processes. The interdisciplinary nature of geoscience research captured my attention early in high school. Within the subset of plate tectonics, there are so many different methods and proxies that we can use to understand how plates move and how the crust is created and destroyed throughout geologic time.
My research focuses on the complex relationships among Earth systems, such as how do plate tectonics build mountains and when. Specifically, I want to understand the Andes of South America that stretch over 4,000 miles. Once these mountains are built, they create a wall so big that clouds barely pass over. This means global climate patterns change, water is diverted, and creates the lush Amazon rainforest on one side, and the bone-dry Atacama Desert on the other side of the Andes. It's critical to understand the evolution of landscapes, mountains, volcanoes, glaciers, climate, and life because they are all related and will continue to be in the Earth's constantly changing system. Earth's history is much like human history, where great civilizations grow and prosper, but inevitably are overthrown or destroyed, and only traces of their existence survive into the present. The record of ancient landscapes, climate, and volcanism similarly have a hard time surviving through geologic time. But as a sedimentologist interested in tectonics, I study ancient rivers or fluvial deposits that are now exposed on the Earth's surface as stratigraphic layers. And just as an anthropologist looks through ancient rubble, graves, or artifacts to understand ancient cultures, we use different stable and radiogenic tools from the sediment record to reconstruct past landscapes, ancient climate systems, and tectonic settings, and to see what kind of life roamed Earth in deep time.
My research focuses on deformation in the middle and lower crust, and dating those deformation events to piece together the tectonic story of certain areas. What is integral to this process is that the rocks have clocks. The mineral zircon incorporates the element uranium when it crystallizes in a magma. Over time, uranium will decay into the element lead. Importantly, this happens at a known rate, which was measured by physicists. This means that if we measure the amount of uranium in a zircon crystal and the amount of lead in that same crystal, we can calculate how old that zircon is. This is the method that was used to calculate the age of the Earth as over 4.5 billion years old. I apply this method of uranium lead dating in various minerals, such as zircon, apatite, and titanite, to understand deformation in the deep crust, where rocks actually flow without being molten. Placing ages on this deformation is important for our regional understanding of how mountain belts form and how the crust rifts apart. Importantly, rifting events are even correlated with extinction events through time, and so this has impact on biological evolution throughout Earth's history. Aside from my research in reconstructing bits of Earth's history, geoscience has really enabled me to see so much of the world. I've done fieldwork in the Greek islands as part of my master's research. I had the unique opportunity to go to Eastern Siberia for a month last summer as part of an international consortium on Arctic tectonics, and I've been all over the Western and Southwestern US as part of my bachelor's and my doctoral research. These experiences were important not only from a geologic standpoint, but as a means of cultural exposure.
To be an Earth scientist, you have to synthesize chemistry, physics, biology, and math, but with the added component of time. These are the different languages the Earth speaks to us in. And as Earth scientists, we need to know a little bit of each dialect. In light of this, one piece of advice I would give to students thinking of STEM careers is never doubt yourself. I think STEM courses can induce a form of self-doubt and anxiety. I would hear phrases like, oh, I'm not a math person, or I just don't get chemistry. But trust me, I wasn't the top student in my high school. I'm a first-generation college graduate, and I went to community college. And that's where I would take my STEM courses, and I had to retake math courses. I barely got through physics, but I just had to work harder. I knew those courses were necessary building blocks to better understand the Earth's language. So if I can do it, anybody can do it. You just need the passion.